so we watched were so gallantly streaming. Hi. On Tuesday, we will elect a new president of the free world and also a president of the United States. A very powerful position in our country. I went around and asked 100 students in the school how they felt about the elections and who they would vote for. And I'm going to represent this with a pseudo electoral map of our school. Let's switch to that map right now. Okay, here's a map of the school. I have it divided into a few regions. I'm going to play through this video and I'll show you what regions which candidate won. The first one is down here in the corner, Gore. He won this region, and this would turn out to be the only region he would win, capturing half of the vote there. Nader split the vote with Bush there. And all these other regions, almost completely voting for Bush. The middle hall had some undecided votes and a few Nader votes. In the corner, that's where the only other vote for Al Gore came from. And so not a very diverse amount of opinions in our student body. And we can see the hall up there and the cafeteria fills. And then finally, the band area fills up. So there you have it, the electoral map of the school. It turns out that Gore won only 8 electoral votes, and the other 92 went to Bush. So that's how it works out from here. Now I'm going to show you some opinions of the students here at Payson High School about the candidates. Now, these opinions expressed may not necessarily be the opinions of PCN or its management. So here, we're going to start it right now.
The issues, everybody knows the issues that they're addressing, and everybody knows the things that need to be fixed. And it's just which one you like better, which personality do you like better. I mean, it's not which one's going to be better in the office, it's just like, which one do you like better? Do you want a Republican or a Democrat?
Whose personality do you like better?
Neither of them.
Gore, he has no character, and his experience is iffy. That 25 years he talks about in Senate and other such political experiences, that I don't buy that. He sells his vote.
Do you think George W. Bush is intelligent enough to be president of the United States?
Well, I don't think really intelligence has much to do with being president now, but he is most definitely less intelligent than I would want the president to be. I feel that Gore is morally weak himself, that he doesn't really have morals. He's what we like to call a baby kisser. He'll say whatever to whatever group of people to make himself look good. And whatever the occasion wants, that's what he'll say to the people. He doesn't really stand for anything.
No, he's a loser, a liar, and a cheater.
Is George W. Bush a loser, liar, or a cheater?
I don't know, but I'd rather him be president than
Bush. He's an honest guy. He isn't from Washington, so I'm a very big Bush supporter.
Well, basically, I see George W. Bush as being basically almost flunked out of college. Who, you know, the only reason why he's going to be a president is because of his daddy's name. And the fact that, you know, he had like a C- average through college and high school kind of turns me off towards him. Whereas Gore, I see him as being a slightly intelligent man, so I tend to lean more to him.
I want Bush to win, honestly, even though he's an ignorant fool, but I think Gore is Satan, so I don't want him to be elected.
People, except for Bush, is a little stupider than Gore. Gore's pretty smart. He's a pretty smart guy, but nobody likes him.
So, Eric, who are you going to vote for president?
Ralph J. Nader? I don't know if that's his middle initial, but I'm voting Nader. I'm voting green.
Okay. Who are you going to vote for president?
Well, I'm only voting for Nader because Eric's voting for Nader. See, I just do everything he does.
So what do you think about Bush being ahead in the polls right now? Why do you think that's
true? I think America's dumb, and they tend to favor dumb people.
Okay, any other last remarks?
Well, high five to Buchanan.
You have to decide who to vote for, because a representative democracy only works when its citizens participate in that form of representation called democracy. So get out and vote Tuesday if you can. If you can't, tell your parents to vote. And just be active in politics. Bye-bye.